I'm Kate St. Clair, the Assistant Director for Programs for Academic Development and Retention at Texas Tech University, and I'm here to talk to you about the case for adopting digital textbooks for PADR students. Between 1990 and 2004, the average tuition at public four-year institutions rose by nearly 78%. In addition to this, by the year 2015, students were paying, on average, $600 a year for textbooks alone. To combat some of these rising prices, programs at many institutions have adopted alternative course materials to streamline and economize college courses for students. The question today is whether or not this is a productive move for the PADR program. This presentation will talk about what today's college student looks like, prior research that's been done on technology adoption, a research study that's been developed specifically for the PADR program regarding the adoption of digital textbooks, and then some recommendations about decisions that can be made based on research results. Today's college students are predominantly millennials. This is an unprecedentedly large cohort of students moving through universities today. Millennials are often called digital natives, meaning they grew up with technology, they're very comfortable with technology. Many of them actually prefer a digital option for the goods and services that they consume. So you have this very large group of students with some specific consumer preferences who are also trying to navigate their college careers while remaining financially intact. Moving to previous research, we know that if a consumer perceives a good or service to be useful or easy to use, he or she is more likely to adopt it, to be satisfied with it, and to continue using it. We additionally know from previous research that students hold some high perceptions of digital textbooks already. First and foremost, they are more cost-effective. Additionally, though, digital textbooks are more easily accessible from multiple devices. They are more readily updated than their print counterparts, and they offer the unique ability for students to link to additional resources directly from the text. The other side of this coin is faculty perceptions. We know from previous research that faculty play an integral role in students' perceptions of new materials, digital materials within the classroom. So, students are more likely to have a high perception of and readily adopt digital course materials if faculty are very knowledgeable and enthusiastic about the product. When applying this directly to the PADR program, we need to ask ourselves two questions. The first of these is, how comfortable do PADR faculty members feel in effectively integrating a digital textbook within the existing PADR program? And the second question is, do PADR students perceive digital textbooks to be advantageous enough to warrant adopting them in future semesters? In order to answer these questions, a two-part research study has been developed. The first portion of the research study centers around faculty focus groups. These focus groups are designed to gather in-depth information on faculty members' comfortability with digital platforms, their ideas on integrating these platforms with the curriculum, and their general attitude towards digital textbooks in general. Because faculty members play such an important role in students' perceptions of digital textbooks, it's very important to spend some additional time with faculty members, gauging their attitudes towards digital textbooks. The second part of the study will be an electronic survey sent to PADR students designed to gauge their level of receptiveness to digital textbooks, and will additionally gather some information on which of the advantages digital textbooks offer that they find the most important. These two pieces of research will work together to provide a framework of information that we can then base decisions on. So, if both the faculty and student groups hold positive perceptions of digital textbooks, the recommendation to move forward with digital textbook adoption can be made. But if either of these groups, or both, hold less than positive perceptions of digital textbooks, then we can ascertain that moving forward with digital textbooks at this time is not in the best interest of the program. This is a very exciting time for PADR. Pending the results of this study, we have the opportunity to provide cost-effective textbook options for students, and in addition to that, to provide some digital resources and a more integrated learning experience for students. I thank you for sharing your time with me, and I hope that you will journey with me on this research endeavor.